Now, in the second part of section 11.1, we're going to deal with the parabolas with a horizontal axis instead. So these are going to open left or right. Now, I told you at the end of the last video that the difference here is going to be that the y is going to be squared instead of the x. So our standard form here is going to be y squared is 4px. And then the focus is going to be, instead of 0p, because this is a horizontal axis the focus is going to be on, so it's actually going to be p0. We're still only going to deal with things whose vertex is the origin. That's the only thing we're dealing with here, and that's what we get out of this equation right here. And then the directrix is x equals negative p, because these are going to be vertical lines now instead of horizontal, since we flipped the axis. All right, so let's take a look at an example. Example 4, we have 2x plus y squared equals 0. So if we want to find the focus and the directrix and graph this, we need to put it in the more standard form. So that's negative 2x. So what is p? We need 4 times something to equal negative 2. So 4 times what? Well, it has to be negative. In order to get a 2, I'm going to have to negative 1/2. Again, over to the side, you can always be doing this. Negative 2 is 4p, so p is negative 2 over 4. So that's negative 1/2. Or you can just be thinking about it in your head if you want. And that's a y squared, sorry about that. So that means our focus, again, I know because it's a y squared, not an x, that I'm going to have p0. So it's negative 1/2, 0. And my directrix is going to be x equals negative p, so the opposite of p is 1/2. Now let's graph that. So let's do it maybe a little bit bigger since we're on the 1/2 scale. 1, 2, 1, 2. So my focus was at negative 1/2. And my directrix was at positive 1/2, so it's 1/2, negative. My vertex is here, so my graph is opening this way. Maybe let's go ahead and plot some points. Remember, we had x or y squared equals negative 2x. So note, we're going this way, so we're only dealing with negative x values, which is good because that's all we can plug in here. So let's say x is negative 2. Then we have y squared equals 4. So that must mean y is plus or minus 2. So if I want kind of the same scale, there's negative 2 and there's 2. So when x is negative 2, y is both 2 and negative 2. Remember, this is not a function. This is not a function. This is a graph, which is a parabola, but it can't be a function because it's not going to obey those normal function rules of the vertical line test, for example. So there we go. There's a rough graph of our parabola that we've got here. Now, the next concept that we want to talk about is focal diameter. And that is, how wide is the parabola when we go its width right at the focus? How wide is it? Because if we have that kind of gives us an understanding of how far up do I need to go, you know, how big is this? Instead of plotting this other point, we could know the focal diameter. Well, the focal diameter is going to be the absolute value of 4p. So let's take a look at what's going on here. So we're looking at, if we're at the graph y squared equals 4px, we're looking at the point x equals p. At x equals p, how wide is the graph? Because that tells us what our focal diameter is. Well, let's plug that in. We have x equal to p. So y squared is 4p squared. So y is the square root of that, so it's plus or minus 2p. So it's going up to 2p, And down to negative 2p, how wide does that make it? It makes it 4p. And we're going to put absolute values around it, because if p is negative, we just flip those guys around. So we want to be careful about that. Yeah, because 2p might be negative. These actually might be upside down. So we want the absolute value. So that's our focal diameter. So if we wanted to, we could graph in that way. Let's look back at that previous graph. So what does that mean? P here was negative 1/2. So the focal diameter should be 4 times negative 1/2. Oops. So that's the absolute value of negative 2, so that's positive 2. So at negative 1/2, we should be going up to 1 and down to negative 1. And that's what we did with our other points. So there's another tool for graphing and to have a better understanding. If we knew the focal diameter, we could find p because we know it would be the absolute value of 4p. And so that's all we're going to talk about the parabolas. You need to be able to then be able to go between the forms. So if I give you the focal diameter and say which direction the axis goes, or whether it opens left or right or up or down, then you should be able to come up with the equation and the directrix and the graph from that. If I give you the equation, you should be able to come up with the focus and the directrix and the graph, etc. Move between those fluidly. And that's all we have for this section.